Hey, welcome to Road to Forever. I'm Terry, and in today's video, I'm answering one of your frequently asked questions from the comments, which is, how do you know if you have a stomach ulcer? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to share some stomach ulcer warning signs, and so these are definitely the early signs, and I'll also share some of the severe signs of a stomach ulcer with you. I wanted to make sure that I give you a little bit of a backstory. So if you haven't seen my other stomach ulcer videos, I've made sure to link them in the description box down below, where I talk about all the foods that I use to treat my ulcer naturally, as well as the foods I avoided with a stomach ulcer. And I kind of also go through my stomach ulcer diet plan. So you saw exactly how I ate with a stomach ulcer. And after, 3 weeks, I actually had relief from my stomach ulcer. So I hope that maybe if you check those videos out, you will maybe find them helpful. But a little bit of a backstory with how I knew I had a stomach ulcer. So it actually started off where, I would have this like persistent nausea and I just didn't understand where it was coming from. And so what would happen is I would go and I'd say, oh, let me have some dry crackers or something like that. And so every time I would eat something, the nausea would go away. And then in that period between when I didn't eat anything, then it would come back again. And I was like, okay, this is so strange. I don't know what this is about. And I just kind of ignored that. Then when at nighttime, when I went to lay down, I just had this feeling of discomfort where I just had this, nausea. I also had this heartburn and I kept thinking like, oh my goodness, am I having a heart attack? But because of my background as a healthcare provider, I knew that these weren't the symptoms of a heart attack. And so I was like, no, this is definitely something else. And, the next weekend I was making a smoothie and I'm like, okay, I'm making this healthy smoothie. It has like spinach, maca powder, almond milk, almond butter, and a banana. So really simple ingredients. And, I took a couple sips of the smoothie and I had like this burning pain in my stomach. And I was like, oh my gosh, like what is going on? This is crazy. And so I was like, okay, let me just take another sip. So I took another sip, couldn't even finish the smoothie. Like I was doubled over in pain and it was burning. So that was when I was like, okay, I think this is definitely like a stomach ulcer because I have this burning pain going on. So I went and I laid down and a couple hours later, the pain still hadn't gone away. I was even drinking water and my stomach was still burning. And I was like, okay, I think I need to go to the urgent care. So I ended up going to urgent care. And the healthcare provider there says, you know what, based on your history and these symptoms, it sounds to me like you have a stomach ulcer. And, they're saying, maybe you can take some over-the-counter medication and definitely follow up on Monday with your healthcare provider. So the next couple of days I went and I saw my primary care provider and, they said the same thing. Yeah, this is definitely an ulcer and these are the medications that we prescribe. And I said, well, if it's a stomach ulcer, you know what? I'm going to try to deal with it on my own at home. And so that's how I got into this idea of just healing my ulcer naturally, which is why if you saw my other videos, I talk about the fact that I didn't take any medications because again, based on my history, I knew that my stomach ulcer was most likely related to my overuse of non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs. So anyways, had the diagnosis, went home and started right away figuring out what I was going to do to heal my ulcer naturally. But if you don't have a background as a healthcare provider, and you're like, well, so what are some of the other symptoms of a stomach ulcer? What I'm going to do is I'm going to put on the screen some of the common symptoms that you'll expect with a stomach ulcer and also some of the more severe symptoms that you can expect. And either way, make sure you always follow up with your healthcare provider so that way you can get accurate diagnoses of exactly what is going on. So while some people do not experience any symptoms at all with a stomach ulcer, the most common ulcer warning signs are things like burning pain in your stomach. So that will be in either the middle or your upper stomach, and that will occur either between your meals or at night, especially when you lay down. Also, another symptom with a stomach ulcer, which I definitely mentioned, was this pain that disappears for a little bit if you were to have something to eat or if you were to take an antacid. Another symptom of a stomach ulcer is heartburn and also nausea and vomiting. If for some reason you have a severe case, some of your symptoms could be things like, black stool. And the reason for this would tell you that there is some type of internal bleeding occurring. You will also have a severe pain in your mid to maybe like your upper abdomen. And also you could experience weight loss. So, based on these symptoms, do you think that you've dealt with a stomach ulcer? If you do, then definitely make sure you're following up with your healthcare provider. Also, what other questions do you have about stomach ulcers? Let me know in the comments down below and maybe I'll answer your question in the next video. If you enjoy this type of content, I ask that you give it a thumbs up, share with your friends, and subscribe for more awesome content just like this. Now, before you leave, I want to remind you, you're only one prayer away. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye. Take care.